Metro Center. As Parham and Travis George set to take the tip before the game. I was walking in the tunnel. Travis George grabbed me and gave me a bear hug. And I was afraid for my life. McNally controlling the tip on Williams. And quick foul on Jason Williams. Max McNally off his feet.
Oliver McNally was in Raymond training camp at the beginning of the season, was released. And this is second season now among the Miracles. And has had some dominant performances actually in late game situations that have beat the Raymond here at the Metro Center.
Mahan now is going to drive on Gats and floats it up from the mid-range. Every bit of the rim but in, and Williams there for the rebound. Gats and bounce pass, and there's Olu Fabutimi gliding in for the dunk. Another look at it here is great bounce pass, splits to the defenders, and Fabutimi on the strong finish.
Nice way for Gadsden to get himself back into the game. Been out of it now for about 3 weeks. Inserted into the starting lineup already also.
George cross pass. And that's Johnny Mahan opening the scoring for the Miracles with a three.
Yeah, and someone that we talked about, the Raymond have got to do a good job shooting it at 37%, the most in the league, and at a very high percentage for a three-point shooter.
Gatson now at the top of the arc as Parham rolls to the net. They don't go with it. Five on the shot clock. Off the screen by Parham, and short on the shot is Gatson. Offensive board, no good. And Travis George comes away with the loose basketball.
In one of the last situations, last games that Moncton played Halifax, rebounding was a major issue. The Raymond got out-rebounded by 22 rebounds, 55-33, and something the Raymond need to address coming in here today against a big, big Miracle team.
Williams down to Parham with a hook in the lane. It's no good. And another rebound for Travis George. Stanley Robinson driving baseline, tries to find Jermaine Daly underneath, but he turns the basketball over. Back the other way comes Jason Williams. Fade away from the elbow, short. And George collects the loose ball. McNally now is a screen fought off by Daly. McNally goes, and Fabutimi picks up the personal.
Yeah, just no help defense there on the Raymond side. Fabutimi's forcing baseline side, but certainly needs to see that there's help where someone can step over and be aggressive on the drive on McNally.
Inbound down low, and it's not going to hit anything, but Cadson can't come away with the rebound, and it's going to be a jump ball situation.
Get a good look here, a nice dump down. Good defense by Parham. Just sticks his hand over. But Raymond got to do a better job on the interior. Points in the paint have been a major issue through the first 28 games of the season.
Fabutimi catch and shoot off the curl. As McNally gets it up to Mahan. Gatson guarding him. He'll pass down low. Parham trying to keep Robinson in the mid-range. Nice bounce pass, right idea, but great defensive awareness by Shane Gatson. And Gatson will go all the way, but gets called for the travel.
Yeah, and the one thing early I think that we really want to key on the Raymond side as far as Gatson goes is we see here he gets a good little attack situation, but he's going up against a much bigger Travis George, and his wind and how his game speed is. It's one thing to go from practice to come right into a game-like situation at this tempo and this pace is going to be something to key on for Shane Gatson.
Mahan with the blow by doesn't get it to go, and it's going to be controlled by Fabutimi. leaves it underneath for Tim Parham. Another travel violation called on Halifax.
Yeah, and some really lackluster possessions here. Raymond not in real, no real flow offensively. Not many guys touching the basketball. You know, that's something that they got a key on if they want to get good shots. The Miracles are a much bigger, much more physical team than both some of the other teams in their division, the Storm and St. John.
Robinson the miss, and back the other way comes Famuteimi with numbers. Leaves it underneath for Parham. Now a kick back to Williams, who passes it up for Famuteimi for a long baseline two.
And I like that from Williams. Famuteimi stepped into a shot earlier already. Give that ball up to a good hot shooter.
Stanley Robinson back the other way. Off the glass. Now he's trying to play up on Williams. Williams had a step, and it's going to be two shots coming as Robinson commits the personal.
Good push by the Raymond. Get it up the floor quick. See if he can get some easier baskets against some of these bigger Miracle players.
Jason Williams misses the first. He's been the most consistent player all around on this Raymond team in his 13 games.
Absolutely. I think he's been a real good player straight through from the time he stepped on the court with the Raymond until now. He's defending extremely well, and he's scoring at a very high rate. I'm not sure when the Raymond brought him in, they thought he would be this type of scorer for them throughout the season, but he's provided a big boost in that area and certainly something to be beneficial for them as time goes on.
Mayhem from deep. Doesn't get it to go, but underneath is George for the rebound. That's a shot by Stanley Robinson. That's going to be his 6th point of the quarter.
And a real lackluster effort there defensively in the zone. Raymond to drop back into the zone, and too easy offensive rebounding and shot selection. Very easy for the Miracles against the zone.
Spinning and going, it's going to be a travel called on Moncton, or I beg your pardon, on Halifax. Fans don't like the call. Third time down the court today that Halifax has been called for steps. Craig Hodges and Don Sellers trying to find out what their guys can get away with and what they can't. And a technical foul coming to the Raymond coaching staff, and will be on the bench.
Very animated Coach Hodges, like you touched on though, Mavs. 3 travels at this time, and certainly only 5 minutes into the basketball game. The Raymond are not in sync right now though, and you can tell that they're not catching the ball in good positions. They're not catching the ball where they can be effective with a finish, and that's why they're getting caught up with their footwork at this stick.
Do you think it may be something with Shane Gatz in his first game back trying to do too much?
I think it's a little bit of both, I think. You know, he wants to get in and get active with his teammates, but he hasn't got up to game speed yet either at that pace. And it's a little bit faster when you've been sitting out for a month to jump right back on the court. And you know, offensively, the Raymond really haven't done much as far as who and what. You want to get the ball to Famuteimi right now, who's hitting shots. You know, get the ball inside, be aggressive.
Now Jermaine Daly back out to Mahan. Hits over the outstretched arm of Raymond Barber.
And once again, as I'm not sure why the Raymond have not addressed, and we talked about this in previous games, Mahan is the only 3-point shooter that shoots with a good percentage.
Famuteimi trading baskets there from the elbow.
And the Raymond got to match up in zone here. They got to identify where the shooters are and who's what in what possession.
McNally with the basket after a hard take. Did not give up on the play with the second effort. Miracle's up 16-9.
And I really like McNally. I think he's a hard-nosed, good player. Someone I thought the Raymond could have kept.
Parham on the weak side of the offensive board. Put that.
These picks in the back row have to, Barber and Parham have to really do a better job of finding and keeping people out of the middle and keeping people out of shooting areas.
As Travis George rattles a mid-range and gives a little quiet the crowd as he comes back down the sideline.
He's going to let you know that he just made a shot. Keep it quiet.
Barber doesn't get that to go, and Mahan underneath for the board. Nice screen set there, and Johnny Mahan with the floater.
What I liked on that possession from the Miracles, though, Mavs, is nice little step-up ball screen, and Barber's really got to get up in that lane if he's going to step out and stop Mahan.
It's 20-11. Johnny Mahan has 10 points. You're watching Raymond Basketball on Eastlink TV. Johnny Mahan being a cheat code in the first quarter. Welcome back to Raymond Basketball here on Eastlink TV. You'll take a look at the Atlantic Division standings of NBL Canada. And it's pretty much the tale of two sides. The Millrats and the Storm are going to be battling for the 1 and 2 seed. The Miracles, the Raymond, battling for the 3 and 4.
Absolutely. And both of those teams, the Miracles and the Raymond, have played the Storm very, very tough this year. The one team, as you touched on, St. John, has sort of had their way with most of the teams in the division. So it should be interesting as time goes on here. The last 12 games are all interconference games and are all going to have a major impact of who's going to get that second or third seed.
Do you think Millrat head coach Rob Spohn wants a shot at his former team, the Rainmen, in the playoffs first round?
I think in theory he would like to play the Rainmen if he knew he was going to win. I don't think he would like to play them in another 12 games when I think the Rainmen will have figured out a lot of the opportunities that they have in front of them to play good basketball.
Tim Parham, you see the smiley face and the sad face on the shoulders. You think that means he likes shooting with the right, not the left?
Absolutely. If you watch the shot real close, man, it sort of turns his hand when he's shooting it. I was watching it when they were playing against London, and you can just see how he sort of flicks it, so you can see how he's not a tremendous free throw shooter with how big his hands are.
Nally passing it down to Robinson, and Robinson's fouled, so he's going to shoot two. It looks like Williams just picked up his second.
A little too aggressive. Famatimi on the shooter. Stanley's a veteran player, rises up just a bit, gets the contact, leans in, two easy free throws here.
And now with 4:40 left in the first quarter, the Raymond kind of have a decision to make with Williams out there with a quick two.
Yeah, and we touched on this, Babs. Gadsden back, whose minutes, and we're seeing right now that it's Juwan Cooley's minutes. He would be in this game. The pace of the game normally picks up when Cooley's in, and we can sort of see how and what's going to happen here over the next number of games, possibly with Gadsden coming back.
Nice ball movement between Good and Williams. As Williams is able to, or Good is able to attack the rim. Is that triangle offense coming to fruition?
Over the long term, that might be what it looks. That's a good look for Good, though. I think for him, he's the type of guy that he's a good step-out shooter. If he can get to the foul line, get two free throws, get into the game a little bit now, he can bring defense away from the basket. He can also get to the painted area. So good chance to get in his rhythm right now.
Malcolm Grant now in the game, replacing Gadsden. good, converts on both. Now just a 6-point miracle lead is. Now he coming across the paint, leaves it for Mahan off the screen, and it's been lights out so far.
And I really like the miracle. See, you can really tell who's in control of the Miracles offense. Oliver McNally gets them to where they want to go. Nice pin down screen. Pop over Mahan. Easy two-point shot for Mahan.
Good. Backing his way in. Drew the double and turned the basketball over. Now he gets it back. And watch McNally and see if he can get Mahan in the corner. Instead, they go the other side. Good forces the turnover. He's able to flip it over his head to Williams. Underneath, and Barber's going to shoot too.
Good defense by the Raymond. Get a turnover, you're able to get down in transition, get an easy look. We see a lot of substitutions now. We're going to get a real good look for Raymond fans out there who are not sure. Trayvon Lathan, who used to be an ex-Raymond, 6'9", can really do it all. Is a real good rebounder, a good scorer, finds his way around, and someone Raymond really are going to have their hands full with here today. And that's what I was talking with Coach Truex before the game. The ability of bringing Trayvon off the bench to provide just 16, 17 points scoring, that's big for any team.
Barber converts them both. Daniel Watkins also checking in there in that mass substitution along with Brandon Webster. McNally and Mahan, the constant. Screen set there for Mahan, a nice ball fake. Working into the low blocks. It's a weak side offensive board. Hesitation, no good as Webster misses, and the Raymond come away with the loose ball. Finds the hot hand to Famutini, but he stepped out of bounds.
Turnovers, man, they'll always get you. Something the Raymond have not done a good job of here in the first quarter, taking care of the basketball. Four to this point, taking away four possessions, cut into this lead from the Miracles.
Back out to McNally. Grant quick on the closeout there. It's an offensive foul. Going to be called on Sylvania Watkins. Barber goes to the rim. Nice layup there by Barber.
That's a real nice layup. Nice power step. Nice laying off the glass. He's really well-rounded into his game over the past 4 months. Being the Raymond's number one pick. He's done a good job. Stepped in and played big minutes. Really learning the professional game.
Another look at it here, Les.
Nice flash, but that's a real good attack dribble. Nice laying off the glass. That's a tough shot to block here. Good footwork. Nice release, nice and high. Good ability to use the glass. That's a real nice move.
Pass back to Lathan. Famutini almost gets a steal. Lathan comes across the paint. Doesn't get it going. A lot of gray jerseys getting their hands on the rebounds offensively.
Absolutely, and it's a big team. You know, Moncton's the biggest team in the league as far as size-wise and athletically. They get after the glass. It's just their ability to finish. They don't shoot the ball at a high rate, so giving themselves second chances, and they're not a real good free throw shooting team or a three-point shooting team, so they got to give themselves some extra looks.
Williams can't hit. Right idea is he's able to shake Alex DeRoche out of Dieppe. Swinging around, screen set. Underneath there for Sylvania Watkins. DeRoche is calling for it on the other side. Watkins goes the other way.
Yeah, and I saw I was watching the news the other day, and I saw a real good article and a good opportunity to watch Alex DeRoche and Matt Robertson and the opportunity to play for Moncton this season, what it's meant to them to play in front of their friends and family. Real excited guys to play professional basketball and to play on a good team like Moncton.
As Williams gets it to Barber, Barber will hold on to it. Nice find down to Williams underneath. He's going to shoot two as Webster's called for the foul.
Good back up by Williams there. A little miscommunication between DeRoche and Latham caused Williams to get open, and now a nice easy opportunity for two free throws.
Good on both, and on the day, the Raymond pretty good on free throws right now. It's 8 of 10, uncharacteristic for Halifax, and that's keeping them hanging around here.
They haven't played really well to this point in the game, but they're right there at this stage. And the one thing they have been consistent in this three-game winning streak is their ability to continue to play defense. It's really helped.
Williams with another board, and back the other way. It's flipped up to Grant now. Turned over, and McNally wide open and driving on the fast break for the easy two.
McNally's a real heady player. I really like his game, and certainly he really controls a lot of what Moncton does.
Grant off the screen. And for Malcolm Grant, that's his first field goal of the day. Merrick was clearing out for last shot as Trayvon Latham working on Famuteimi. Kicks it back out to DeRoche. DeRoche won't get it to go. With that, a slow start, but the Halifax Raymen are within a possession. So trailing the Miracles, 25-22. You're watching Raymen basketball here on Eastlink TV.
Raven on the post. All right? Now, let's get the ball. Go ahead and get it to your wing. Let's get that back doorstep that's wide open. Now, don't stop with your cuts. You had a down pick on that, you didn't go, and you were standing. So hit your back door, down pick, right into your dribble wing. All right? So it'll be you, Raven, stepping. If you got your movement, go. If not, go into the dribble wing with your guard coming out of the corner. That'll be Malcolm. Yeah.
Boxing big out away from the rim.
Hey. Make sure when you're blocking out, get them away from the basket. Go make contact early.
You dive, okay? Trey, come from the side.
Someone start, whoever starts strong side, slide. Go up and get them like we're fucking running up. And then go sit down.
Yeah. Hey, come up and get. He's going to come up and get you. You just go opposite corner, then you turn down. Hey, good start here. At least we're not down friggin' 20 points here to start. Let's keep that energy going. Serge?
I like Craig Hodges telling the guys we got to clear out underneath on the offensive boards because there's been way too many gray jerseys getting tip-ins and getting their hands on the misses.
Yeah, and it's one of the things he talked about the next day after that overtime loss was how bad they got beat on the glass. Anytime you get out-rebounded by 22 in a game, you're giving up a lot of second chance opportunities. And in an overtime game, That's something that's going to be the difference. Let alone the Miracles missed six free throws in the last minute to keep them in it.
McNally to DeRoche. DeRoche hits for three.
Big set coming out of a quarter timeout, getting DeRoche open. Good shooter, really good shooter. His confidence really improved his game.
Barber going across the paint with the hook, and Barber's been finishing everything.
That's a real good take. You know, the big fella's really rounded out his game as far as how it's going. Two times today, nice little lay-in off the glass.
Watkins, looked like he forced it, but was able to get to go.
Rebounding leader last year in the NBL with the Miracles.
Popped out to Famutini.
Famutini right now is 5 for 5. I'm suggesting you get him the ball. As it's underneath for Brandon Webster and clear up for the big man. He's coming down.
And it hits sort of what we see a lot in the first couple of quarters. They like to play up and down, up and down. You get a good opportunity, get some easy baskets. Raymond got to lock down a little bit better here on defense.
McNally is, DeRoche is going to the weak side. It's Trayvon Lathan. Gets his shot over Chris Matthews.
Nice attack, dribble, just pushed him off just a little bit with his right hand. Creates some space, step back jumper.
Grant fights his way through his screen, back down to Barber, who's gonna shoot the fadeaway, back iron, and another one and done for the Raymond. Bounce pass down to Lathan, Lathan off the glass, and here comes Famutini, who'll kick it over to Malcolm Grant. Grant creating a shot for himself. No good, but Barber chases down the offensive board. Turns it over, 2-on-1 for the Miracles. Working on Matthews, under to DeRoche, and DeRoche with the finish.
Yeah, and right now I think the Raymond need a timeout. They're offensively right now, it's too much one-on-one. The ability to not get back on defense. You know, you don't want to get the Miracles feeling confident here in the Metro Center. These teams have played extremely close games, and to certainly give up as many easy points as you're giving up right now, you got to get something confident. Get it to Barber right now, who's feeling real good, or Famutini.
It's going off the foot of Famutini. Trayvon Lathan creating the steal, and Mahan checking back in for the Miracles. Shane Gatson and Mr. Energy, Robert Norton.
Yeah, it's nice to see Norman come in the game, but certainly, you know, we're in that situation again, Mavs, where Juwan Cooley has not entered this game yet, and we've played 15 minutes. He's the steal leader in the NBL. He creates a lot of different opportunities for the Raymond. He changes the pace of the game, the tempo of the game. And right now, nothing's really going the Raymond way. It's something, you know, I'd like to see him get in there and get this game going, get this pace up to a 50, 60-point pace here, and see if the Raymond can change the tempo.
Drive by Lathan, a foul, and I believe Vince has got something on Juwan Cooley. Vince, what do you got for us?
Guys, I spoke to the training staff of the Halifax Raymond, and Juwan Cooley is dressed, but he's inactive today. He's got an X training, he's day to day.
Well, that explains that. Thanks, Vince.
Help side, help side.
It's a drive by Mahan, doesn't get that to go. DeRoche trying to force the turnover in the full court. Shane Gatson reverse layup the other way.
Nice finish by Gatson. Right hand on the left side. I got to touch on something I saw this morning, though. They were talking about Terrence Ross scoring 51 points last night, Mavs, for the Raptors. And they asked Kyle Lowry after the game, what do you do? How do you continue to get him shots? Just give him the ball. Just give him the ball. That's what they got to do right now to Famutini. You know, he's not on the floor right now, but he's 5 for 5. You got to get him the basketball. Raymond have got to address some of those situations.
You see Don Sellers, and I think that might have been his reaction to the call.
I think he's been frustrated a little bit since the first quarter, I think. Picking up the technical foul with a couple of travel calls. defensive fouls.
After the game, make sure you check out Eastlink On Demand for Sportsland when we had Sellers on this week for a great 15 minutes. It was very entertaining.
Nice.
It's passed back down to Gadsden. Pump fake, then goes, and the miss, DeRoche, the rebound. And that's his second board as he'll bring it up the court. Stops his progress and passes back out to Trayvon Latham. Stolen away, but the recovery there by Mahan. The alley-oop from Mahan to Latham.
Wow, and if, for anyone that didn't see that, Trayvon just put his hand up just for a quick second. Mahan threw that right to the corner of the glass, and you see the athletic ability of Trayvon Latham, a 6'9", not only a point guard, but can jump out of the gym right here. We see he throws it hard to the corner of the glass. Nice catch and finish.
That's 9 points off turnovers for the Moncton Miracles. And right there, you see that's the difference right now, 40 to 28. Is DeRoche, a bounce pass, and another bounce pass down low. Webster has it knocked away, though, by Robert Nortman.
The big fella's got to finish that. That's a real good pass.
Malcolm Grant down to Nortman. Nortman can't finish. Tim Parham will just pop it out to Grant. Another miss. Parham able to finish on the third opportunity.
And he's laying his body in there now. He really put a good shoulder into Webster. The Raymond got to be more active in this zone, though. There's too many seams that are able to be passed through. Too many opportunities, especially leaving good shooters open.
Mahan with the miss, but Brandon Webster is able to come away with the unsecured rebound.
We're starting to see that difference now between the rebounding edge. It's starting to pay off for the Miracles.
Grant gets it to Nortman as he was double-teamed. Nortman looked like he rushed that shot. DeRoche comes away with a loose ball. Latham calling for it down low. Great recognition, though, by Grant to come in and steal it. It's a battle on the floor, and well, Alex DeRoche comes away with it.
That was real good hustle by Grant. Latham battled hard to get it back.
And there's a turnover. A little helter-skelter basketball right now by both squads.
Might need a TV timeout if we can get one here.
It's coming up next whistle as it's down to Robert Nortman. Unless, just what the doctor ordered. Raymond are down 10, 42 to 32. You're watching Raymond Basketball live on Eastlink TV. Well, Olufamutimi is 5 for 5 on the day. Played for Team Canada. Strong for Halifax this afternoon.
Yeah, and we touched on him at the beginning of the game, Mavs. He's an aggressive, aggressive player and has really stepped up and shot the ball well. And this is the type of situation the Raymond got to continue to look for to get him into situations where he can be successful like this. He's shooting the ball at an extremely high rate now, and he's feeling real, real confident. So you got to continue to get it to him any way that you can. Get him the basketball. You know, he's sort of been saddled in the first half now with a couple of fouls, but certainly it's, you know, the opportunity for him to go out and hit shots. He's played really, really well.
But you can't get him the ball when he's sitting on the bench, Les. I'm not quite sure the...
Yeah, I think it's just, you know, it's the substitution time at this point. You got to get Matthews in, get him going. You know, you want to get Williams going. Parham sort of more involved now into the game. So
The area of concern for me right now, though, is their defensive philosophy. They just got to pick up harder. They got to find more guys, not give up easy open shots.
Cordell Jonte in the game now for Moncton. As Gadsden gets a steal on Jonte. Coming down the lane, and it looks like it's going to be a foul on Mahan. That's his first. Gadsden goes the other way, off the screen, off the glass, no good, but once again, around the rim was Tim Parham.
And the big fella coming off a 14-point, 14 rebound effort in St. John. You know, he's starting to get more involved now. He's laying the lumber in there defensively and getting in on the offensive glass. That's what the Raymond need here if they're going to get back in this basketball game.
And Jason Williams just picked up his third with 5:09 left in the second.
That's a big foul. I don't want to see him stay in here too much longer in this first half. It'd be a real good opportunity right now to get Famatini back in the game. Someone who's played real well. You don't want to see Williams pick up a fourth foul, especially here in the first half.
Gadsden back down to Matthews. Gadsden trying to clear out for Parham to come over for the screen. Creates a shot, gets that to go.
You see, there's just a little bit of confusion offensively.
Back the other way, catch and shoot by DeRoche, and just missed by Alex DeRoche. Mahan's going to get called for the foul. That's going to be his second. Coming up, playing the body aggressively, arguing his case. Norman now working from the elbow back to Gadsden, now back to Norman. He's able to get the defender to bite, drives hard to the basket, and he's going to end up shooting two.
Got to convert here if you're the Raymond now. You've played good defense the last couple of minutes here. Get yourself back to a 2-1-shot possession, maybe get the lead here by halftime. They haven't played real good basketball to this stretch in really in the whole game, so.
As Norman misses both, and Jonte cleans up the glass. Back down to Mahan, Williams closing in on him, but back to Lathan. Now Mahan open, launches from deep, but Truax has given him the green light to shoot that shot.
Yeah, you know, that one's a little deep though. He shoots it at a good clip and leads the league, but that one there, that was about a 34, 35 footer. That's a real tough shot.
Matthews, speaking of stretching the floor, he draws iron on that one, but now it's back over to Gadsden on the skip. He'll leave it for Matthews, who dribble it over to Williams. Parham underneath, sensing a mismatch, doesn't get the go, but Norman, offensive board, can't get that to go. Third chance opportunity for the Raymond, and Williams is going to shoot free throws. And Truax doesn't like the effort underneath the glass of the Miracles.
No, and nor should he. You know, that's Williams in there battling. They get Raymond get 3-4 good looks. That's the energy. Norman on the glass, but right there, Williams, you see four Miracles and none of them come up with it. Coach is going to be upset every time, but good battle by the Raymond. They're battling back in this game right now. They're not getting any shots to fall, but going to the glass is going to give themselves second, third, fourth opportunities here. And this really is one of the smaller lineups that you'll see for the Miracles. Cordell Jonte, ex-Raymond player, one that I coached myself, happened to guard Tim Parham. That's a tough matchup for the Miracles.
Offensive board off the missed free throw, and the Raymond chance to cut into this lead. Block shot there by Trayvon Lathan on Gadsden. Back the other way. Dennis Shruax wants a foul, but and now a steal as DeRoche leaves underneath for Lathan. And there's a swing.
Really?
Just as I'm about to talk about the Raymond getting back into this, it's back to an 11-point basketball game as Williams almost has it knocked out of his hands there.
Absolutely. That was a big stretch here in the first half. Some careless play from the Raymond. We really see the difference now without Cooley in the game. He really provides that energy and the tempo for the speed of the Raymond. Really out of sync here offensively.
Mayhem leaves it underneath, and two shots coming for Watkins. Have a look here. Back the other way goes Trayvon Lathan. Gets it to go, and then underneath. DeRoche gets his hand in the passing lane. And Watkins cleans up again.
Yeah, real good steal there by DeRoche to stay active on the basketball. Raymond Legas. Say, really too careless with the basketball offensively and leading to 48 points right now here in the first half. That magic number of that 100-point plateau where the Raymond seem to struggle, anytime offensively gets over that, they really struggle to win basketball games. So.
Travis George checking into the game. Not sure what he had to say to us, but he was saying something.
I think he was letting us know that he's ready to go now. The big fella's not going to get any more rebounds on the glass, so good matchup here between Parham and George.
Problem with Timmy back in the game now for the Raymond is they also got in Raven Barber. Williams shot from the free throw line, doesn't get to go, and it's tipped in by Travis George.
Barber's giving them a good presence here in the first half. Both Barber and Famatini have really stepped up and played well for the Raymond early.
Mayhem with another touch, and it's going to be over to DeRoche, and DeRoche steps out of bounds.
Nice extra pass. You got to know where your feet are, though. It's a good decision by Mayhem, though, to give it up to DeRoche, who's hit one in this quarter.
Barber now, leave it for Famuatimi and gets himself open. No, a nice pass back to Raven Barber, spin, gets that to go over the outstretched arm of Cordell Jonte.
And Mavs, you're seeing a nice little array of moves here from Barber. The rip and step through and go, and now a nice little turn, jump shot.
Nice battle on the wing between Mahan and Grant. Travis George feeding it down low to Jonte, and Jonte goes off the glass and in.
Yeah, and used his body real well, right? Felt Famatimi really pushing hard against his back. Nice spin move, veteran move. Cordell doesn't take a lot of shots, but he makes a lot of shots when he does shoot.
Tim Parham with a tough basket over Travis George.
And the Raymond have certainly had good success laying it off the glass on the right-hand side. Defensively right now is where the Raymond are struggling. If they can pick it up defensively, they have a good opportunity here.
Travis George turns it over. Coming up at the halftime with Vince Williams, it'll be a sit-down with Chris Matthews. That's coming up at the half. Raymond trying to get this, or keep this within single digits. Going into the break. The miss there by George. Here comes Malcolm Grant. Over McNally, no good. McNally chases it down, and Miracles are going to hold for last shot.
And that right there tells me of where the Raymond are offensively. You had the chance to hold that for one shot. And you give up a nice easy shot at the end of the half. Offensively, a real bad half for the Raymond. Need to come out and play more focused basketball offensively here to start the second half.
with the Miracles up 52-43. It could have been a whole lot worse for Halifax.
Yeah, to only be down 9, you have to be pleased. But at this stage, it's the way that they're playing, and that last shot tells me that typifies sort of how the offensive flow was in the first half, not recognizing how much time is left on the clock, no rebounders in rebounding position, and all of a sudden you take a quick shot. That's not something Malcolm Grant does a lot, but they got to address this as they go forward here in the second half.
Vince Williams has Raymond head coach Craig Hodges on the sideline.
Thanks, Mavs. Coach, Olu seems to have the hot hand. How do you keep him involved in the offense?
Well, the main thing, we just have to move the basketball and move people. It's not so much our offense, it's our defense. We're not playing with any energy, enthusiasm, and it's like we just want to write the game off, man. And it's sad to see that we come out like this.
And what type of adjustments are you going to make defensively? You switch to a zone, go more man-to-man in the second half?
Well, the main thing, we're going to bring energy regardless to which you want to play, whether man or zone. You have to bring energy to play either. And right now, we just don't have the energy in the building that we need.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Yep.
Raymond continue the trail. You're watching Raymond Basketball on Eastlink TV.
better start is the question this half. You know, you're already down at this point, 12, offensively. Got to get something going to the basket.
Dami Sapara with a long two. Our first look at Sapara today.
Yeah, and you know, starting the second half, so Coach Hodges sees something different within the group. Real athletic player, super aggressive.
Farhan going to get called for the personal. Came pretty strong on that block.
I tell you what, Mavs, if you're going to foul somebody, this is the type of foul in the paint. Right through the arms. That's two big men right there. Parham's got to move his feet over, though. You don't want to be giving these guys opportunities, especially to put themselves in the bonus situation as the quarters go on. Get down, move your feet, don't give up the basket, defend and rebound.
As in it goes, as Travis George, he's loving silencing the crowd here today.
He's not a great free throw shooter, though, so I think the Raymond will continue to take one for two if he gets there.
Gadsden underneath to Parham, and Parham is going to have it knocked out of bounds, and it's Miracle Basketball. McNally, only 4 points in the first half. Open for three. Can't hit, and Sapara gets the board, and foul coming on Jermaine Daly.
Yeah, not a smart foul by Jermaine Daly. 94 feet from the basket. Those are the types of fouls when there's 5 minutes left in the quarter and you have four fouls. You commit one, all of a sudden now they're shooting the bonus.
Gadsden off the clear, oh no good. George with the seventh board of the day. Nelly, driving kick. Mahan can't hit, and underneath, the Miracles contain it. From the weak side of Travis George, fouled, he's going to shoot two more.
And the easy, like I touched on, Mass, if you watched Oliver McNally on this last possession, you look, he just a little tip to his teammate where he knew where his teammate was, gives his team a second chance opportunity. Good foul by Famitimi, I believe. You know, make Travis George make two free throws. But real, real smart by Oliver McNally. Not trying to out-jump people, just tapping the ball where it needs to go.
Well, he did go to Harvard. They usually have some smarts.
And I'm sure he's a real bright student also. But man, I wanted to touch on the London Lightning have been struggling.
They have. And in the game that we saw last week, and then to go up against St. John, Atlantic teams to be knocking off the London Lightning. That's a big red flag.
Absolutely. Big second chance opportunity there for the Miracles.
Brian can't connect, and George, that's his eighth board. George up at the top of the arc is going to leave it for Mahan, and six in the shot clock. He's going to try to create, launches it up, almost gets it to go. He draws iron, and George gets the rebound. Continue the possession for Moncton. Got his guy to leave his feet, but very short on the shot. Dami Sapara will leave it for Gadsden. Williams sets a screen. Gets it back to Jason Williams. Famitimi wants it in the corner. Williams will drive. Now sends it out that way, and it's an offensive foul on Jason Williams. And that's going to be his fourth.
Yeah, and I think it's the indecision right now of the Raymond. Jason had a real good opportunity on a catch and shoot opportunity there, but didn't take the shot. And all of a sudden, McNally steps in and plays real good defense, a real heady player. Steps in, puts his body right in front of Williams. Real smart play from McNally.
McNally leaves it. Hold on the wing there, a miss by Stanley Robinson. Gadsden pushes it up to Famitimi. Back iron, picked up by Mahan, who leaves it for McNally.
stops his dribble, and he's got a pass out of it. Mahan, the trailer, will attack the rim. And just off the glass and in was Johnny Mahan.
That was good D by Barber, but I want to address it. It's not the quantity of shots, Mavs, it's the quality. And when you watch the Miracles play and you see McNally, you see all of his teammates get quality shots. As Gadsden just lays a floater up in the lane. The Miracles are getting the shots they want. They're not going to shoot 100%, but Oliver does a good job of getting the ball to them in the right spots. And right now, we don't see that on the Rainman side.
Push off there and foul on Robinson. And Chris Matthews about to check in for Halifax. But yeah, it's Gadsden's first game since January 2nd, so he did talk about how he's probably in shape, but not game shape quite yet.
And offensively, it's in sync offensively with what and how you're trying to do what you want to do there. And we're seeing a little bit of confusion and taking quick shots.
As Gadsden can't get that to go. Back the other way, Mahan over Famutini. Famutini made it as tough as he could for him. Mahan, just that little bit better. Matthews for three, doesn't get the going. Pass back out for the Americans. Americans lose it. Here comes Gadsden. McNally just going to stop the fast break in its tracks.
It looked like a smart foul by McNally. I think he thought there was an easier opportunity for guys to go up and score, so that's why he fouled him. But right now, it's all Miracles here to start this third quarter.
Gadsden off the screen by Barber, attacking the rim, and it's going to go off the fingertips of Chris Matthews waiting. Oh, and on the wing. Another turnover. It's their 12th turnover of the day.
Yeah, and we need. And at this time, there needs to be a timeout. Let these guys know that it's not what we're trying to do offensively.
Mahan calling for it on the other side. He lobs it up off the rim and back the other way. Comes Dami Saparo. It's not going to count. It'll be on the baseline. Nice recovery there by Saparo. He's fouled.
He's pretty quick, Mavs. He got the ball. He was as fast as anybody down that floor moving. No chance for McNally.
Saparo turns on the Jets, but is rejected at the rim. It's going to stay Raymond basketball with 15 on the shot clock.
And that's why you got to have players like Travis George. Real good rip and go by Saparo. He gets to the rim, and who do you meet? 6'10", Travis George waiting for you at the glass. Nice block shot.
Swinging around the outside. Matthews jab stepping. Now he's going to test the range, and that's the first three of the day for Halifax. Now he coming off the screen, fouled about it. Now he'll pass around. Back into Robinson, working on Barber, driving the double, but now they'll work their way out of it. Tack to the rim, and a beautiful take there by Stanley Robinson.
Nice attack to the middle of the lane. Look for that fellow to finish with his left hand.
Saparo leaves it underneath for Raven Barber. And Saparo's been a nice injection of energy here in this second half.
Yeah, the speed of Saparo. No one can stay in front of him right now.
Mahan on the miss, and Raven Barber.
Got to get that ball up the wing to Saparo right now. Get him the touch.
To the rim goes Matthews. And to be last touched by Moncton, and when we come back, Raymond trying to regain some of that confidence they had in the first half. They're down 64-52. You're watching Raymond Basketball live on Eastlink TV.
gotta play harder. Harder. We gotta play harder. Everybody gotta play harder. If we play harder, smart might come along with it. But harder gotta happen. All right? Rebounds you gotta get. Three of us gotta go to the backboard on offense. Five of us go as a collective defensively. Then we get out and run. They gonna let y'all back in the game. In 2 minutes, y'all be back within six. All right, now, y'all gotta be mindful to make it happen from that point. All right, let's go, man, let's go. Play harder.
When we come back for another timeout, can we talk about some different stuff?
Okay. Play harder. Win on three. One, two, three, win.
Within 2 minutes, they'll be back to within six, is the prediction from Craig Hodges.
Well, hopefully, you know, his guys will respond to that. And certainly, we've known throughout the league those types of things, the ebbs and flows of the game, you know, the runs that teams go on. Certainly, they could go 8-2 or 6-0 and put themselves in that position. It's just that they got to work so hard to get them back into it. So let's see if they can respond. And certainly, having Sapara in the lineup at this stage, he's given them that influx. And that's where I think Juwan Cooley, they sort of missed that transition of him being able to get up and get going, certainly with the steals and how he responds offensively.
Sapar will leave it for Gadsden. Gadsden with a nice move in the lane, but he's rejected by Travis George. Mayhem. Trying to create some mayhem. Now off the screen set by Daly. Daly open. High arcing shot. Raven Barber able to adjust that.
And it all starts on the defensive end. If you want to get back within six, you certainly got to stop them. Continue to play good offense.
Chris Matthews is starting to heat up.
We know he's capable. 18 points in one quarter here in the fourth quarter. A couple of games ago, so he certainly has the shooting touch to be able to do it.
Mayhem for three from the baseline.
And if you see that, McNally gets into the lane, could have kept going, wasn't much range difference between to make that pass, but he knows Mayhem's a shooter.
Bounce pass down low for Matthews, but it's going to be turned over. We're going to see it's a foul on the Rainmen. And that's going to have the Miracles shooting the rest of the way.
Yeah, and just a little bit of bad luck there. You know, Barber's battling her for the basketball and sort of bumps him, so you get two shots. But that goes back to what I addressed earlier. A foul that happens early in the half that you do not need to commit. Now a team's going to shoot two shots for no reason. That would just be an end line out of bounds. Not that Travis George is a great free throw shooter, because Moncton, that's the one area that they do not really play really well, is shooting the basketball. So, you know, this is an opportunity here that's missed from the Rainmen.
As he hits the first,
two easy points possibly from 94 feet away. Not a smart play, especially when you're trying to get back into the basketball game. It's just that it seems the Rainmen have to battle so hard all the time, all the time. They can't get themselves out to a lead and really play off the energy of the crowd too much.
Well, I know at halftime we were talking with our producer, Matt Morris, and we were trying to figure out the last time the Rainmen had a lead going into the half. The one time that I can recall right now, they seem to have trouble playing with the lead, as Gadsden is going to get called for the travel.
And I think he traveled twice. He definitely traveled when he caught it, and certainly, you know, but just playing too fast, not playing to the strengths right now. Execute offensively, and that's where, you know, when I watch Oliver McNally and I watch Al Stewart, I watch some of the other point guards in the league, these guys do a good job with their teams.
Matthews now on the wing, he's going to pass it off to Gadsden. And Gadsden tests his range, doesn't get to go. McNally with the board, and foul coming, and two shots coming for Oliver McNally. And Sapara gets called for the personal.
Yeah, and you know, you're quicker, you're faster. Keep him in front of you. Don't send a really, really good free throw shooter like McNally to the line in a situation like this. But it goes back to offense, man. That's not a good shot. They're able to get out in transition. And it's sort of creeping away a little bit here. You know, we're looking at a 16, 18 point gap possibly. You know, and Raymond have to continually battle back.
Good on both, and into the game comes Trayvon Latham. Nice. McNally catches a breather.
Pretty good trade-off. I mean, anytime you can take out Oliver McNally and put on a 6'9 point guard, Trayvon Latham, not a bad matchup as a coach.
Barber is going to shoot two as he's trying to cut into a 9-0 run by the Moncton Miracles.
You got to get away from the one-touch shot. One-touch shot. More Raymond players need to touch the basketball offensively. 3 to 4, 5, 6 touches before someone gets a good shot. Right now, it's just too easy. The ball's bounced somewhere, quick shot, no movement. And Coach Hodges will tell you, the one thing he did play is in a system where the ball got to Michael Jordan in the end, but it went through a lot of different players first.
As Barber hits both. Daly's got to get her into Mahan. Mahan will bring it up to Cortis. Nice battle here between Mahan and Matthews outside the arc. I mean, those are two the premier three-point shooters in this league. Is a tip in there by Brandon Webster. But everything's falling for the Miracles right now.
Yeah, and there's no secret. You know, this is the sixth game between these teams. They know what these players can do at this stage. You know that Webster, you know that George are going to be around the glass.
Hooking the lane good for Raven Barber.
Great finish. An outstanding game. An outstanding basketball game from Raven Barber to this point. Needs continue to get him the basketball in big spots.
A steal there by Malcolm Granny. Chases it down. Trying to convert into the points as Barber comes. And crowns Jermaine Daly.
And that might be it right there, Mavs. That might be the play that keeps this team going. A tremendous run of the lane and a great finish. You won't see many better dunks than that at this level.
Daly on the miss. It's kept alive by Latham. Back the other way comes Sapara. Lobs it up for Grant. And he'll put on the brakes. And mid-range jumper good. Dennis Truax wants to take a timeout. Senses the momentum leaving and
absolutely
just puts on the brakes. Smart coaching there.
Quick 6-0 run by the Raymond right back to where we started the half.
Have another look here at that steal, and Grant keeps it alive and senses the man coming. Look at him just coming down the lane. Get out of the way, sir. You don't want to look foolish. And there's Malcolm Grant getting his.
Quick 6-0 run right back into the basketball game.
You're just going like this and chucking shit. They're going zone. Okay. Who else I got out there? Johnny. Hey, we hit the high post. When you go downhill, this guy's got to go here. And if you're going to throw it high. Don't bounce past it. Throw it high and finish strong.
Hey, we're in bonus. No more shots. Attack.
Hey, let's go.
Point basketball game. The Raymond trailing. And the former commissioner of the CBA, Dennis Truax, taking a timeout.
Yeah, very experienced.
Finish strong.
Very experienced minor league veteran, both coaching, administrating, knows a lot of players. Has had some really good players in Moncton too. This team, by the time it all shakes down, is going to be a tough out for anybody in the playoffs.
Latham off the screen as he comes across and kicks it back out to Mahan. Mahan unable to hit. And Raymond come away with the defensive board. Here comes Grant now. He creates his opportunity and rattles home a long two.
Starting to feel it offensively. The Raymond are, and it's all being picked up by defense.
a lob up and kept alive, but it's going to be into the hands of Dami Sapara. And Sapara, the big finish over Mayhem. And the Metro Santa Raymond faithful, after seeing back-to-back dunks, have a reason to cheer. Trayvon Latham the miss. Battle down low. Webster comes away with it, and he's going to shoot two as Raven Barber is going to get called for the personal, I think. That will be Barber. We have another look at the dunk here. Just a play to try to keep it alive. And Dami Sapara with the athleticism attacking the rim.
Get excited, Big Bill. Tell us how you feel.
He's excited. Gee, I'm not sure where he was in the first half, but certainly he showed up here in the second half with coach's opportunity, and he's played his heart out.
A native of Staten Island, New York.
His speed is what's the difference. His speed has gotten them opportunities through transition and gotten them out on the fast break, and you can see by that ability to finish the way he did there. Good to see. Long way to go, Mavs. Long way to go. 9-point game, still quarter to go.
Turnaround jumper, no good. And Malcolm Grant trying to steal, but Trayvon Latham comes away with it. Latham passes into the first row. And it's going to be another turnover. And this will be the first time the Miracles have more turnovers than the Rainmen. 15-14, Grant, bounce pass, but Barber, the attack, he doesn't finish, but he's going to shoot two. Raymond doing a great job attacking the rim.
Absolutely. Things have really picked up, but that's what we talk about, the ebbs and the flows. How can you really control when the other team's going on the run? Well, you can call timeout, as Coach Truex did. But now you can still see the Raymond's defensive energy is still there, and they're still able to get out a couple more easy looks. This game could be down to a 7-point game. And you have to feel, as well as the Miracles played this quarter, all of that's really been taken away in the last 3 minutes to end this third quarter.
Barber, right now you saw he had 17 points. That's on 7 of 10 shooting. Make it 18 with the free throw. Mayhem coming off the screen. He's in for Stanley Robinson, and there's a finish inside.
That was a real tough finish by Trayvon Latham. He had big hands all over him. Raymond would do well here if they could get a good offensive set, maybe a high screen with Barber and roll.
Barber's rolling now as Grant fires up. Oh, Raymond takes it to go!
Big three at the buzzer for the Raymond. Big shot, Malcolm Grant, the last 3 minutes between him and Barber. 12 points, real good shooting, good opportunity now going into the fourth.
The Raymond trail by 7, 77-70. You're watching Raymond Basketball live on Eastlink TV. Points and 7 rebounds through 3 is Raven Barber.
Yeah, and the skill set that he's shown is what I've been impressed with. His array of footwork and his ability to run the floor. You know, nice little laying off the glass. Reverse dribble, nice pullback, nice shot here. He he's done well, and he's really just adjusted to how he's been being played defensively. Once again, Howard here, great finish. That was the one that got the fans going, got everybody energized. Need to continue that here. This is very winnable game. For anyone that's not aware, these two teams, between these six games, it's like a plus two between them. So we expect it to go right to the final shot, and who executes the best will win the game.
Let him harass 22 coming down, and then he's going to pass him off to one of the bigger guys.
Okay. Exactly. Come on, man, right now, let's go.
So we a man.
Let's go. Win on
three.
One, two, three, win.
This is a Raymond team that played them. They got the Miracles four more times. The key, though, moving forward past this game, they have a five-game road trip. They got to win one. And they've just signed the third Canadian.
Looks excited. Abe Tulaney out of Mount St. Vincent University. Former Sir John A. McDonald Flame. Played overseas. Just waiting for FIBA clearance now to be active. He's been practicing this week with them. So it'll be good to see how he adjusts and how the Raymond adjusts to what he may do in the coming weeks.
Good to see another local product on the court of the Metro Center. As a Raymond finally address the need for the third Canadian player. As DeRoche, Canadian content for Johnny Mahan. No good, but it's going to go off the foot of Chris Matthews. And now DeRoche puts it on the court, drives on Jason Williams, doesn't get the go, and Barber is there for the rebound.
The execution has slowly gotten better for the Raymond. Let's see if they can continue here to start in the fourth quarter.
Grant off the screen of Matthews. Just can't get it going right now. He's 2 for 7. Raymond only 2 for 5 from beyond the arc, very uncharacteristically.
Absolutely. That's something that they tend to and have done a really good job. Coach Hodge is obviously a three-point shooting wizard. I'm sure he's brought that to a lot of practice and continued to shoot the ball a lot. So
as Grant's trapped in the corner by John T. And short on the shot, Trayvon Lathan the rebound. Passed off to DeRoche for three. Beg your pardon, it's going to be a long two as Al King gives me the peace sign.
Nice to see Alex getting minutes at this time of the game. Bench play and production off the bench is big, just like Sapara has been for the Raymond.
Williams doesn't get that to go, and Mahan the rebound as Malcolm Grant is going for the steal. Now Jonte back over to Lathan. Lathan to the rim strong. Trying to go up and over his own player, it looks like there. Grant back the other way. He's going to lob it. And a recovery by Williams. Now helter-skelter basketball between the two squads. And that is a finish to Trayvon Lathan from Alex DeRoche.
Yeah, and it seems so far, like throughout the first three quarters, all the 50-50 balls to this point have really gone Moncton's way. This step, outside of some offensive rebounding, which has really kept the Raymond into it. The little touches, the little turnovers here and there have all seemed to have gone Moncton's way to stem the tide. And this is a fellow that will need to get going today. Is Gadsden. He's taken the most shots today, 2 for 11. Anytime you're coming back off a long extended break, you take those shots. You got to make sure that your team's real effective. And he has an opportunity here in the fourth quarter to make up for a relatively subpar performance to this point.
Sapara into Barber now. It's going to go off the foot of Gadsden, but instead they'll get it back to Matthews. And it's going to be Miracle basketball off the miss.
I think at this stage, the Raymond really need to continue to look into Barber. You got to play through Barber for the next 2 to 3 minutes, see if he can get you continue good shots. Maybe you get a double team and you get open for a good look, but you got to play through him on the offensive side.
Matthews now
He's going to kick it back over to Latham, and Gadsden can't recover. He's just rejected by the rim, and here comes Shane Gadsden with the rebound. Stopped his progress. DeRoche there making a tough one. He's passed off to Matthews and Cordell Jonte. He gave him that lane. Just a miss by Chris Matthews.
Yeah, not a real good matchup for Cordell, certainly. You know, Matthews is the much quicker athletic player on the dribble, so. Right now, though, we really need to address getting the ball to Barber. Everyone needs to space, get the floor into a situation where you're going to get good shots, and Barber's got you a good shot every time today.
And that's the fifth foul on Jason Williams, so Famutimi checks back in, or beg your pardon, they're rolling with Williams. I thought they were going to make a substitution, but Williams is... got five with 8:46 left in the fourth.
Yeah, and the reason I think Coach Hodges would leave him in is he's a veteran player. He knows that he has five fouls. He's not going to put himself in a situation where it might cause him to have to leave the game with his sixth foul. So I think if he didn't know that, I think he would take him out. But I think he's pretty confident at this stage.
Jonte working on Barber. Works his way into the lane, off the glass, and only got the new 24, but Lathan, nice spin on the reverse layup.
And it's those long arms, the 6'9 ability of those long arms to get up and lay it up over heavy traffic.
Matt Williams to the rim, and he's gonna shoot too. Off the drive, foul there on Watkins.
Yeah, and Williams much quicker, more athletic than Watkins in that case also, and he can get him into the lane anytime he would like. Good rip and good attack. This might be something that they can get Williams going with here. Couple free throws. Raymond have shot it well from the line today.
Not the balanced scoring attack, though, that we're used to seeing from Halifax. Is only 24 points from the bench. You see a lot more even distribution of the basketball.
Yeah, absolutely. And we've seen over the last number of games, 5 to 6 guys get into double digits. Not there today, and that's why I'd really like to see it get into Barber a lot.
As DeRoche misses on the three, and Sapara's underneath for the rebound. Williams, spin move on McNally, he can't get the go and gets his own rebound, another chance, it doesn't go, and it's going to be Raymond ball, but he didn't touch the rim. They have 12 in the shot clock.
Yeah, Raymond have to get into a quick screen and roll situation here, I expect, with Barber.
Sapara working off a screen by Barber, rolling to the basket.
It's
going to stay Raymond ball two on the shot clock.
Yeah, expect a pin down here. Look for Famutimi to come off a Barber screen or Williams to come off a Barber screen to catch and shoot. If you're the Miracles, you got to get ready to defend. Everybody on white's got to get to the glass here. You know you're going to be shooting it quick. There it is.
And a miss there with the Miracles up 83-72, trying to cut into the deficit.
Yeah, sort of just matching basket for basket here. Collectively, you need another spurt, and they still have a spurt in them at this stage, but they're gonna need it pretty quick here to get into a 4 or 5 point game.
Latham leaves it for Jonte, and Jonte open for a long two.
Back to that zone. More energy, just need more energy defensively in the zone.
Gadsden back over to Williams. Williams hits for three, and that's a spark of energy the Raymond need as it's now a 10-point game with 7 minutes remaining. Here's McNally now. Bounce pass down low, and up and off the glass is Sylvania Watkins.
And that's the ability there, see, of Williams He doesn't really want, he can't play him as aggressive with the five personal fouls. And Watkins, as we know, big, big offensive player, big rebounder, finishes it well.
Famutimi with a long two. Keeps it a 10-point game.
Got to get a couple stops here if you're going to be there. Coming down the stretch.
Safara matching up with McNally. In the wing, pass back to Jonte. Jonte working on Barber. Spins out of it. Kick it back to McNally. Now over to DeRoche. DeRoche for three. High arcing three. Big shot for the Varsity Red.
Big shot. That stems the tide on the road here.
And there's a steal, and now up to McNally for the easy finish. 92-77 with 5:50 left, and another Rain Men turnover.
Yeah, and the energy's really, really swung towards the Miracles of this day, so we need a timeout. You can see here, Gadsden's really had a tough game. Lathan seals it on the crossover. Nice hit ahead by DeRoche. Playing with a lot of confidence, Alex DeRoche. Great defense by Tremaine. Trayvon Lathan, though, to get that out and get a steal. Quick 5-0 run. 15-point game.
You're watching Rain Men Basketball live on Eastlink TV.
Boom. All right. Just slide over here. Yeah. Slide right there. All right. And we run it the other way. We run it that way. Boom, boom. It's got to be quick. Boom. Slide.
You know, interchange.
You slide. Just slide. Slide. And then move the ball. You ain't got to move the ball. But damn, we got to stop somebody down there, man.
Come on,
yeah.
Come on, let's go, man. Come on. Fight on three. One, two, three. Fight.
Got
6 minutes, man.
I will come off, slide, and come off. You get here, you kick. If it's not there, slide, you dive. Hey, put it away. Let's go.
Let's go, man.
Shots to net. Miracles up 92-77. And Truax is trying to get his troops to put it away.
Absolutely. He knows. Playing here at the Metro Center, nothing's easy. They've seen 15-point leads evaporate real quick. All it takes is a quick 3 minutes. You go 9-2, get yourself 7-8 points back. Going into the last 3 minutes, you got a chance to win this game on your home court.
Back to Watkins as he spins on Williams. Doesn't get the go. Back the other way comes Famutimi. He's been an energy guy and hits for another long two.
Famutimi and Barber have played outstanding basketball. It's the energy of the rest of the Rainmen today so far to keep them going.
McNally now to the rim. The miss there, DeRoche underneath, battling hard, and the Miracles turn it over. George Good. We haven't called his name a lot today as he flips it up. And five minutes left here in the fourth, and they're arguing right now about the score. Our score bug is down, but I do know that the Miracles were given 2 extra points here.
I think the correct score should be 92-79. It was a 2-point field goal by Famutimi. They addressed it by putting a 2-point up on the Rainman side, or on the Miracle side, sorry. So the correct score should be 92-79.
Dennis is getting in on the action here. Is 92-79 with 5 minutes left here in the fourth.
Some good defensive play. That's two good defensive possessions. You can close this game out, hold them at about 97, 98 points. you're going to have to score 20 and 5, but certainly it gives you a chance.
Williams is trying to create his shot. Parham setting a screen on DeRoz. Now into Famutini, back into Williams. And Williams. Trayvon Lathan got a piece of him. He's getting called for the foul.
Didn't look like he got much of him, but certainly that was a real good defensive possession by the Miracles, and to finish it off with a free throw. Williams is starting to find his stroke a little bit now. You know, hitting a quick three. Couple free throws here. That's 7 points in the last 2.5 minutes out of Williams. Hopefully he can continue this as the time goes on.
Williams is 6-for-8 from the line today.
I expect to see a little pressure here. Take the ball out of McNally's hands. Maybe make Alex DeRoz, maybe make Trayvon Lathan, somebody else bring that ball up, especially with 4.5 minutes. McNally does a good job of tempo. Get it out of his hands.
Williams good on both, and it's an 11-point Miracle lead with 4.5 left. Here comes Watkins up the court with good on him. He's going to leave it for McNally. Has Lathan on the weak side, DeRoz in the corner. Instead, McNally tests his range and doesn't draw anything. Ball's still in play, so back the other way is good. Good, he's going to shoot two.
Yeah, and a smart play by Matthews to get that ball up quick. Now, hey, you're scoring points with the clock not moving. Right, that's what you want to do if you're the Rainmen. Continue to play good defense, have them hit shots.
And that's six fouls here on Silvania Watkins. Truax going to Stanley Robinson. So good on the day. He's only played 8 minutes and he's been injected for some energy here in the fourth. Is off the back iron on the first.
Yeah, and I really like to see Sapara get back in. If we could see him for the last 4 minutes, he played real well for this second half, and his speed and athleticism caused a lot of problems. The Raymond went on that run. He was a big part of that, so it'd be nice if they could get him back in.
Making it tough on the inbound, and we'll get it over. That's gonna be, it's don't finish. Another missed opportunity. It's going to be Miracle basketball.
And tough luck for the Raymond there. A quick shot out of the Miracles. Two quick misses. You got to corral that rebound. Everything's been going your way. 4 minutes to go here.
McNally calling for a screen by Travis George. Pops it up for Stanley Robinson, and two shots coming for Monkston.
I think this is where the Raymond missed the opportunity. The Miracles are not a really good outside shooting team. You gotta pack the paint right now. Outside of Johnny Mahan, who's really, you know, the top 3-point shooter in the league, if you key on him and you stop everybody else in the lane and you force them to take a shot, your chances go way up in this basketball game.
Robinson good on both, and into the game Raven Barber. So Barber bringing, after getting a fresh rest, he's got 18 today, and he's going to try to put the team on his back now. He's up the top, distributing the basketball over to Famutini, and it's going to be out of the reach of Jason Williams, and another turnover. And McNally fighting off the full court pressure. Able to advance it over the timeline. Nathan will be over on the other side. Travis George coming out for a screen for him. Williams sticking with him. Latham hits the brakes, and he's going to last touch by the Miracles. So great defense played there by Halifax. Nice hurry-up offense here as well. Now Parham dribbling into the painted area. They'll kick it back out to Williams, though, who's drawing a double. Parham kicks it back over to Matthews. Chris Matthews for a long three.
Big three. That's a big shot. They really searched hard for a shot in that possession. Continue to play good D. Make the Miracles take tough shots. Crowd the painted area. Don't let Mahan get off.
McNally with space now. Swung around from Robinson and Latham. Latham keeps his dribble alive. Long shot there by Travis George.
And that's a big one. Shot clock expired.
That's found money.
That was a big shot by the Miracles.
Bobby Teamy now on the baseline. Good for the mid-range.
Once again, though, if anybody's watching, you see the Miracles. The tempo is where they want it. The shots are where they would like to get. Not many Raymond touching the basketball late. Not much flow, just sort of one-on-one, hoping to create.
Latham to miss there, and Parham an easy rebound with no one around him. Down 10 with almost a minute 30 left. Williams turns it over as Latham with hand the passing lane. Numbers 3-on-1, and the reverse layup finished by Travis George.
Yeah, and a little careless by Williams to give that ball up too early on the double team.
Matthews trying to make something happen here. Can't get it to go. Offensive floor going. Shot there by Obi Famatimi. Good.
It's too bad to see. Olo and Raven Barber have had two fantastic games. But once again, Mavs, we're at that 100-point plateau where the next basket gets them over that. And we know the success is not high when the Raymond give up that many points.
As Matthews sends in to McNally, and gonna see full shot clocks used here with the Miracles.
Yeah, he's not gonna give the ball up easy till it's late in the clock.
Looking to snap their three-game losing streak, and to the rim goes Mahan, doesn't get to go, and underneath Famatimi there for the rebound, and played in there by Olu Famatimi. Truax wanted a timeout, but didn't get to the table in time, and the foul there by Famatimi, but 99-91 with 44 left. And two shots coming.
In the
for
bonus,
Mahan.
In the bonus both ways here now. Now you really got to hope that the Miracles do what they did in the last game. Miss six straight to get into overtime. This is not the fella that you want at the free throw line, though. Johnny Mahan. Complete all-around game today. The Miracles did a good job today. Really came in, played well. The first two quarters got themselves a nice 10-point lead, 9-point lead at half, and really continued well in the third quarter. Just not the effort and the intensity required again today from the Rainmen to play and finish this here at home.
And Mahan with the easy basket underneath.
They're gonna get four more shots at these guys though, so there's still lots of time left. You know, just gotta play well, and they get a quick shot at them as Famatimi hits another shot consistently.
There's underneath Raven Barber for two, but
They're going to go right back at it again Thursday night.
Lob there from Trayvon Latham to Travis George. Matthews to the rim. And the Raymond now going a five-game road trip to try to do something they haven't done all year. That's win a game on the road.
Yeah, they're going to get right back at these Moncton Miracles Thursday night. Going to need a complete effort if they're going to keep up and get out of the cellar of this division.
You all right?
Not the balanced scoring effort we've seen from the Halifax Raymond this year.
No, Shane certainly struggled coming out of the gate in his first game in over a month. Both Barber and Olufemitimi played fantastic, but not having the change of pace in Cooley, both offensively and defensively, that really hurts the lineup. Did a good job on the glass overall, but too many turnovers at key times and the inability to continue to play defense for 48 minutes is what's costing them at this stage. And they really need to now find a way on the road to win a game so they can have some confidence moving forward.
Moncton going to 10-19 on the season. The Raymond 6-23. We get a quick look at the play of the game here. Latham just trying to create, but a deep three there by Stanley Robinson.
Yeah, up seven. This was a big shot after the Raymond had just hit a big three. No time on the shot clock. Stanley hits a big three and really sealed it for them.
Final stats here, you see, he has 105-97, 4 of 12 for the Raymond from beyond the arc. Uncharacteristic shooting night for Halifax.
Yeah, and they did a good job on the glass tonight against a bigger Miracle team. You know, they all rebounded them by 8, but certainly 25 free throws in your own gym and the shooting percentage really, really high.
Well, we're going to throw it down to Vince Williams, who has Johnny Mahan of the Moncton Miracles.
Thanks, Mavs. Johnny, the Raymond kept it tight in the first 24 minutes. What changed in the second half for you guys?
Just basically, we started turning the ball over at first in the first half, so it was kind of tight in the first half. So we kind of stopped turning the ball over, started making our free throws in the second half. We was making good shots, and then we just, you know, built on the lead.
In terms of separation within the division, how huge is this win today?
Oh, it's very big. Coach is telling us in